and Dateline in Atlantic City.
Oh, thanks, Steve. Steve Allen. Oh, no, it was Marty Allen bringing us back. Steve Allen, a frequent guest. Marty Allen, even Steve Rossi. Hey, do you ever have trouble with that, Steve Allen? Steve Rossi, Marty Allen. How about the combo?
Not while I'm eating, no.
Okay.
Doesn't come up.
How about Rossi and Martino? Martino. No, no.
Nope.
Al? Okay. All right. Forget it, Rossi. Martini and Rossi on the rocks. What am I talking about? Hey, we're having a ball tonight. This is just a few moments left in the show, but I have to tell you, we did not need, if we required a lift tonight in spirits, we didn't need one because we had a full moon, a high tide, and three enchanting guests. Some enchanting guests, but Henny Youngman certainly providing the fabulous touch to the final half hour of Dateline with Sonny. So let's say right now that we're going to keep it going, keep it banging, as we say on Dateline Atlantic City, with a young gentleman called Frankie Randall. And Frankie, we really haven't spoken about you that much tonight, which you don't mind because you're there. But I have to say something about Frankie. When I say you're there, I mean you're happening. But I have to say something about Frankie. Frankie also is a versatile individual.
Fine pianist, too.
And I know this gentleman. I know this gentleman for a lot of years. And he was a former vice president of entertainment at the former Golden Nugget in Atlantic City under Mr. Steve Wynn. Or maybe over Mr. Steve Wynn. I don't know. But, I mean, you certainly were there with Steve. And later with Bally's when Bally's purchased the property. And now you have gone back to the left coast. You're originally from New York, from Clifton, I should say, but New York, really. And the thing I always remember about Frankie Randall from the older days when I knew him well, was when he was working at a place called Jilly's in New York. And when you speak about the real saloons and the saloon singers that gathered there, including a guy called Francis Albert Sinatra used to come in and catch you there. Frankie, as a young guy working there, that had to be a tremendous thrill for you.
They were wonderful times, and that was a great room. And it was right next to the Alvin Theater in New York City on 52nd Street. And it was just, like I say, great times, wonderful people stopped by. Of course, Sinatra was in all the time.
Yeah,
I was, too.
You were?
Oh, yeah.
And it was terrific because night after night, I'd play piano and sing my songs, mm-hmm. and Dean Martin might be next to me one night, or Judy Garland,
or Jayne Meadows,
or Jayne Meadows. it was just a terrific time.
Frankie, will
life.
We ever recapture those times? I doubt it. Right?
I don't think so. Yeah. I think it was. I'd like to think that we would because it was just fun for everyone. I think it was a different world that we lived in.
By the way, big bands are coming back, and small audiences are coming with them.
And Steve, I want to say one more thing before we
say six more things. It's your show.
Okay, we only have time for seven more things. Really, a minute a thing. But at any rate, Steve, what I have to tell you is that, he's so mean. Wait a minute. Now you made another point. What'd you say? Why'd you throw me off my cadence? I was driving that
You're
cadence
so
well.
I didn't even know you had a cadence. Are you kidding?
Listen, wait. I forget what I was going to say. Oh, I know what I was going to say. I was going to give it like a disclaimer
right.
to Henny. And we can speak about him now. He's not with us. But he said about no late night show carrying on the tradition of Steve Allen. To me, there's only one, as there is to Henny and Frankie and Jayne. And so many of our listeners and viewers, really, Steve Allen, the granddaddy of them all. Nah, but the original TV funny man. He invented the style, the form, the format, and everything about it. Spontaneity was his deal. However, there is one guy today doing it, and he concedes the fact that Steve was the man. And I do find David Letterman, as I said before, refreshing to watch if I ever get the opportunity. But when I do, there's so much of Steve Allen as far as material in David, and David does acknowledge that. Steve, do you agree with that? I mean, when gives a blanket statement about nobody to watch on TV, I agree with him greatly, but not when it comes to David.
That's true. Of course, his head was covered up by a blanket when he made that statement. But no, it's very nice of David. Seriously, he does a lot of my routine. The other night, he did two of my routines, but again, he says he's doing him, so that makes it okay by me.
Mm-hmm. No yeah. question about it. Okay, right now, Okay by Me is the time of my life. It's the song that we spoke about earlier that was written as a ballad by Steve Allen, one of the 4,800, and Frankie Randall when he, you tell her. You got the song, and you looked it over.
And
it was a ballad.
And along with it, Steve sent me a variety of people that had recorded the song, and they were all ballads. I said, you know, as a matter of fact, in Steve's show, he does the one I have, the one I love belongs to somebody else, which is, like he says, probably one of the saddest songs
written
ever written.
A ballad, yeah.
Written as a ballad, he said, but the sign of a good song is that
you can swing it.
You can swing it, and that's exactly
and that's what you did. Right now, let's listen to Frankie Randall swinging as he sings Steve Allen, The Time of My Life.
I've had the time of my life. Oh, yes, the time of my life. I guess things never could be so lovely for me again. You were the belle of the ball, I was the king of them all. No other man could dispute my claim. Tell me you feel the same. I had the time of my life, for sure the time of my life. And you're the reason and rhyme that I had the time I had. And now with all of my life in view, I'll pray as I often do, that I can spend all the time of my life with you. I had the time of my life. Oh yes, the time of my life. I guess things never could be so lovely for me again. You were the belle of the ball, and I was the king of them all. No other man could dispute my claim. So tell me you feel the same. I had the time of my life, for sure the time of my life. And you're the reason and rhyme that I had the time I had. And now with all of my life in view, I'll pray as I often do, that I can spend all of the time of my life with you. And now with all of my life in view, I'll pray as I often do, that I can spend all of the time of my life with you.
Okay, we are having the time of our lives right here on Dateline Atlantic City. What a great sound.
Great lip sync, too.
Thanks.
No, really.
Fabulous.
Yeah. He was singing along with it, but that's not easy to do. I tried it once, and my lip sank.
And they're selling that CD at the hotel.
As a matter of fact, I go out every night because they are. Well, that's as tough as the one you have, selling them out there.
Out there, right.
And I autograph them for the folks, and they just, it's flip. Lots of fun for me. Yeah, they
right.
flip.
Right.
And do you accompany? Are you accompanied by the Furco String Band?
No, the Furco String Band should do. What is a frame, though? I think.
Yes, one of my old mistakes.
Okay, right now it's kind of wrap up time. Sad to say wrap up time, but we have had the time of our collective lives.
Well, I'll tell you how much fun I had.
Yes.
I completely forgot that we were doing a program. I felt like I was at a party on this couch.
Well, wait a minute. And are we doing a program?
Well,
go ahead.
You know, it has been like a party. And I'm talking, and the microphone isn't in my hand. I'm like this. Yes, well, I no
don't do it again. Don't do
and
it
no
again.
No microphone.
All right, well, now you have a microphone.
Yes.
Let's say that, once again, our joy, it's just been delightful, as always. And we're very incredibly talented, gifted, and good people. That's
You'd
what I
surprised.
Want to say. this guy. It's always good. He's another Henny Youngman. That's right. See, when I grow up, I want to be like Steve Allen, as I always say. When Steve grows up, he wants to be like
Henny
Youngman.
Everybody
that's right.
Does. Everybody
does. No question about it. But I want to be like all of you, because this has been a joy for me, without question. And nobody's going to question that. Right now, we're going to say that. To wrap it up as we... By the way, thanks, Jayne, so much. I know you're all very busy.
I've been looking forward to it, Sonny.
And
really.
Steve,
thank
as
you,
always.
Sonny. I've been looking sideways at it.
Okay, and Frankie?
Sonny, thank you very much. It was great seeing you again.
Always great being
and
with Frankie.
And you are handsome.
Oh, don't tell that to anybody.
You
Listen,
are.
Right now, let's wrap it up as we do every night about this time and on our weekend editions as well with our main stick, expressing for Jayne Meadows, Steve Allen, Frankie Randall, Sonny, and all of our listeners out there in both radio and TV. Exactly what we want for the entire world. So, as always, Mr. Ray, kindly take it away.
I see trees of green. roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white. The bright, blessed day, the dark, sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. Much more than I never knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
What a wonderful world. That's right, Louis Armstrong. Satchmo Pops Lewis taking us home as he does every night about this time, his handkerchief and all. Yeah, Louis Armstrong, that's right. And we want to say once again, we've had just a marvelous time tonight, as always on Dateline, but tonight very extra special to Sonny. We want to thank our guests, our special guests once again, Steve Allen, Jayne Meadows, Frankie Randall, and Henny Youngman. And until tomorrow night at 9, when we have much more fun and games ahead, this is Sonny saying tomorrow night at 9. What do I say? I know. Until tomorrow night at 9, and Sonny Schwartz saying thanks so much for listening. Feel good. Stay ahead of the posse, y'all. Good night, Thin Man. 30.
Dateline Atlantic City has been brought to you by Trump Plaza Hotel and Casino on the Boardwalk, Atlantic City's only 4-star, 4-diamond-rated hotel casino. By the Sands Hotel Casino, Merv Griffin's Resorts Casino Hotel, celebrating 15 years as the first game in town. The Grand, a Bally's Casino Resort. Brought to you by the Claridge Casino Hotel, because smaller is friendlier. Trump's Castle Casino Resort, where service is king. Bally's Park Place Casino Hotel and Tower, Atlantic City's winning address. And by the Atlantic City Medical Center. Quality health care right in your own backyard. For Dateline Atlantic City with Sonny Schwartz, I'm the Baron. Have a good evening.